everybody. It is always a privilege of professors to announce that they are provocative, that they are looking over the whole area. And it is quite unusual when a commissioner is saying, I'm provocative. And I assure you, I am provocative. And I will take that opportunity. I'm not, by the way, only provocative. I'm also pragmatic. I'm Dutch, so you get what you see and what you think. And to add one other issue, I'm solution-minded. If we are indeed all interested and involved in solutions, then this is the moment, and this is indeed the occasion. So I'm grateful to those organizers who put you together. They promised me they won't let you go before there is a general, so to say. So talking about indeed what the professor was mentioning, talking about citizens, consumers, talking about the industry, they badly need clear signals, and not only clear signals, but clear positions, so to say. I hope you are aware that we indeed published a digital agenda. I wouldn't mention how the procedure and the process went on. Result counts. We cleaned the ceiling of the bloods and the tears and so on. But here it is. It is commission results, and it is backed by the commission. That's not unimportant, for that is indeed the difference with my former portfolio, and you are aware that I did enjoy that portfolio. But just then, it is between you and me. This portfolio is more creative and is more innovative. So I'm indeed up to the job, so to say. By the way, and that is very important when we are talking about the digital agenda, it is, and this portfolio, it is managing nearby 26 colleagues in the college. For it is horizontal, it is connected with all the other fields, and we have to deliver, no doubt about that. There are 100 actions in the digital agenda. There are more than 31 legal pieces that we have to fill in. There are thousands, if not millions, of crucial partners, including each of you in this room. And this is an action plan. Yes, it is. It is absolutely essential for Europe's long-term economic recovery. And it depends on us working together effectively. And that is what I'm really looking forward to, for it's also about communication. And that was one of the main challenges I had in my former portfolio, when someone was just addressing me in the supermarket and was asking me, what are you doing? That I could give them the feeling what I was doing. And it is the same now. And I don't need to explain to the younger generation, they are explaining to me what I should do. But there is a generation that we still badly need and that we have to involve. So it's all about communication. And also for that process, I need you. So I'm asking you to engage with the wider agenda and to bring that spirit of partnership to the dealings we have on radio spectrum. And perhaps you might wonder why you need to get involved. Well, I touched upon it already. And isn't this just like all the other strategies of the past, you might be asking? No, it's not. My firm answer is no, it is not. It is not like the other strategies. And it's about far more than a single issue, and more than telephones, and more than geographies. It is not limited to ICTs. It is a unified agenda which recognizes convergence in the digital world and which puts digital issues at the heart of the group's plans for the future success. Whether it is saving taxpayers' money, raising productivity, or dealing with aging or with climate change, you will find a contribution in the digital agenda for Europe. And if this plan succeeds, then you and I will succeed together. Of course, you are here to focus on the radio spectrum policy program. I am aware of that. And naturally, I'm pleased to confirm that it is an important part and the focus for immediate action of many issues on the digital agenda. Successful spectrum policy pivots around efficiency and prioritization. And like many items of the digital agenda, the technological challenges come together with wider political and cultural challenges. And, ladies and gentlemen, we know that is, and of course that is why I'm pleased, that we have a head start on this issue to begin implementing the DAE. And we have a new regulatory framework, and we have started dialogue earlier, most notably through the Spectrum Summit held in March. And the new provisions in the telecoms reform package will contribute to the DAE by ensuring that spectrum resources are better managed and are available where most needed, for example, for delivering broadband connectivity at reasonable cost. And stronger emphasis on technology and service neutrality in spectrum use will also make it easier for new technologies and services to be introduced. But the reform package also gave increased significance to the need for coordination of spectrum policy at EU level, and that was already mentioned by the professor. This will culminate in the adoption of the spectrum, the radio spectrum policy program by the European Parliament, by the Council, the proposal for which will come from the Commission after the summer. And so far, as well the European Parliament, anyhow all the commissions that are involved, so the economic one, the cultural one, they are backing us with the digital agenda. The same for the different councils, they are backing us. So let's go for it. And the idea of developing a spectrum program reflects the growing political awareness of the importance of the radio spectrum in achieving some of our key objectives for economic recovery and sustainable growth in the European Union. And at the Spectrum Summit, I said that I was determined to inject economic and social sensibilities into the debate, and that I will not allow technical and legal arguments to have more influence than they deserve. I will give them an eye, but not more than you really need. And judging from the comments of other speakers at a summit, I did not feel that my view was isolated. And since then, we have the adoption of the radio spectrum policy, of its opinion on the draft program, which I very much welcome as an important and positive input into our proposal. And we now have all the key inputs needed to prepare the program. So no excuse anymore. So while I will be interested to hear about the discussions that you have here in the conference today, tomorrow, we can already see some of the key points that arise following the Spectrum Summit and the public consultation, and again, the RSPG opinion. First and foremost, we need to concentrate on the digital dividend. The timely use of existing spectrum bands and broadband, and the inevitable demands for more spectrum, for that is, of course, going on. Well, of course, efficient use is key. This is a principle that applies across all bands, and I believe more could be done to just pinpoint those parts of the spectrum where improvements are needed. And it would be silly to say that no improvement could be made, that is crazy. And another important area that we must address is creating the right conditions for the introduction of innovative technologies. And then I'm talking about, for example, cognitive radio. And these are still relatively unknown, but they have the potential of significantly increasing spectrum sharing and efficiency. So we cannot allow a mistrust of change get in the way of progress. And then there is a challenge regarding national reassignment of current rights of use, what's called the reforming. Well, pushing for making